wild shootout on Highway 580 early Sunday morning.
You can hear some of the shots from the intense 12-minute gun battle that took place between CHP officers and a suspect early Sunday morning.
Byron Williams, a parolee with two previous bank robbery convictions.
Byron Williams, the man involved in that violent shootout.
Authorities say Williams was headed for San Francisco,
armed with three guns, a bulletproof vest, and a whole lot of ammo.
A police statement says he wanted to start a revolution.
Wanted to start a revolution.
Start a revolution.
By killing people at the ACLU and the Tides Foundation.
For 30 years, the Tides Foundation has fought to promote human rights, justice, and a healthy, sustainable environment. And Byron Williams allegedly sought to end all that in a hail of gunfire.
We believe that he would have carried out his mission, which was to go to San Francisco and commit some violent crime there with the ACLU and the Tides Foundation. And that's just based purely on his statement to us.
Williams was apparently targeting those groups because of their civil rights agendas.
The Tides Foundation was the topic of conversation many days on Glenn Beck's Fox Cable News show. Beck many times railing against the organization, speaking out against them, what they stand for, and what they do.
In exclusive audio obtained by Media Matters, Byron Williams can be heard from the jailhouse talking to a freelance journalist. He lays out his distorted worldview shaped by right-wing talkers like Glenn Beck.
Yeah. Think like a conspiracy theorist.
Okay.
Except don't use the word theory.
Right.
The conspiracies are not theories. The official part is the lie.
He considered Beck something like a school teacher watching the show for its conspiracies.
I don't think he's a natural leader, you know what I mean? I look at him more like a school teacher on TV. You know, he's got them big chalkboards and those little stickers and he's got, I like the way he does it. He's got a lot better at it.
This is indoctrination in the purest sense. They have to get you while you're young, or you're going to reject this nonsense because you know better.
You know, I would have never started watching Fox News if it wasn't for the fact that Beck was on there. And it was the things that he did, it was the things he exposed that blew my mind. Beck would never say anything about a conspiracy, never advocate violence, he'll never do anything like of this nature. But he'll give you every ounce of evidence that you could possibly need.
Much of his motivation seemed to come directly from the distortions perpetuated by Glenn Beck.
The last couple of weeks I've been telling you about Crime Inc., and I'm telling you, this is the biggest thing we've ever done.
You might as well start calling our government Crime Inc.
By the time we get to the end of Crime Inc. here, whoa, you're gonna think, that is strange.
And he's got Crime Inc., Chicago Crime Inc., and he goes on that.
This administration is crippling the American competitors of Petrobus right now. So what's in it for us, Mr. President? Nothing. Nothing is in it for us. But there is something in it for the players of Crime Inc. At one time, George Soros had $900 million invested in this company. Now, before you dismiss the connection, look how much influence the Soros Center for American Progress has on this administration. Soros buys $900 million in gasoline-powered bras. Then, in a completely unrelated story, BP has their oil spill.
Like Obama on the 12th, he causes the oil spill. Either Soros or him or BP themselves contracted Halliburton to sabotage the oil.
We're showing you the circle of deception in the Obama administration and the BP oil spill. George Soros has nothing to gain from this. He's just telling the president what to do through the Center for American Progress.
Obama and Soros are one person. Soros is completely socialist. So is Obama.
Billionaire investor dumps money into a state-controlled Brazilian oil company. Days later, the American administration dumps $2 billion into the exact same company? What are the odds, Gilligan? The usual suspects. Let me tell you here about George Soros. It's all funded right through the Tides Foundation.
But the strange thing about it is that the Tides Fund is right next door, and the administration
administration transfers the funds from the foundation to the fund.
Tides, in case you don't know what Tides is, Tides Foundation is with Soros. Did you notice some of the names involved here, especially the Tides Foundation? Tides Center. The Tides Foundation.
It is the reason why the blackboard became what the blackboard is because I was trying to explain Tides.
So Soros got himself set up a little system where rich people can donate and remain anonymous.
I just throw this message out for the people at the Tides Foundation. I'm coming for you. Oh, I'm coming for you. Oh, no, not a... Glenn Beck making threats? No. Mm-mm. Nope. I'm just going to reverse all the things that you have done.
See, now I'll tell you. Beck is going to deny everything about violent approach, deny everything about conspiracies, but he'll give you every reason to believe it.
Oh, yeah. I'm coming for you on the battlefield of ideas.
He's protecting himself, and you can't blame him for that. So I understand what he's doing.
For almost 2 years, Beck has inundated his Fox News viewers with violent rhetoric.
We are really, truly stepping beyond socialism, and we're starting to look at fascism.
I think you're about to witness a country burning down to the ground.
It's September 11th all over again, except we didn't have the collapsing buildings. We haven't had death camps here, and I hope to God we never do. But all it takes is one insane leader to put us on that track. Grab a torch.
I'm going to find these big progressives, and to the day I die, I'm going to be a progressive hunter.
Yeah, drive a stake through the heart of the bloodsuckers.
Do you think he's got a political movement? I mean, hundreds of thousands of people came out to hear him speak.
I think so.
Yeah.
There's hundreds of thousands of us, yeah. And more and more people are waking up.